Yo, happy Friday, and welcome back to Bleacher Report's eStream. I'm Malik Forte. On today's episode, we have Madden Competitive Gaming Commissioner Matt Marcoux to break down the Madden Championship Series. Let's do this. Joining us in studio today is the Madden Competitive Gaming Commissioner, Matt Marcoux. How you doing, man?
I'm doing great, man. It's good to be here.
Thank you, man. Thank you for joining us. Lots of questions to ask you, but first off, can you explain to viewers what your role is as the commissioner?
Yeah, just like my title implies, I'm the commissioner, I'm the boss. A lot of people kind of see that as like, I'm like the sheriff, I'm there to clean up, you know, all the miscreants and people who are trying to cheat. But you know, the commissioner, as commissioner, there's a lot of things I look out for. You know, I do look out for the league operations. You know, some days I'm like the Dean Blandino of the sport, but I'm also looking over our production quality and our marketing and our sponsor relationships and, you know, the general kind of information we give out to the community.
Right. How much involvement do you have in the actual development side of the game?
Oh, quite a bit, actually. We have a development roadmap specifically for competitive gaming features, right? Yeah. So in-game tournaments, you know, quality of the gameplay, other really cool features that keep people competing and ranking up on the ladder.
That's awesome, man. So yesterday, EA kicked off the Madden Classic, which is the first major under the new competitive gaming structure.
Yep.
How is this season different from what EA has done in the past?
Yeah, as you just said, it's structured, right?
Okay.
So, you know, going into the season, we announced the $1 million tournament, and we announced the four EA majors and slew of premier and challenger events throughout the year. So
Nice. That
this year was about structure. It's like, you know, having a clear prize purse, having a clear schedule. The prize purse going from $100,000 to $1 million, pretty significant. So it's all those little things that allow someone to be a true professional at their craft.
I was like, what was it that made you guys hunker down and build this structure?
We saw the opportunity.
Yeah.
You know, Madden has been on the forefront of competitive gaming for a decade.
Oh, yeah.
But the
yeah.
support for it has been inconsistent. So we wanted to fix that. We really wanted to get behind it and provide that consistent structure. We wanted to be the organizing body of the sport of Madden.
Nice, nice. All right, so can you break down the new rules and the format for this head-to-head competition?
Yeah, so actually, this competition is not head-to-head. So Madden, a lot of people just think of Madden as Panthers versus Broncos.
Right.
You know, you pick one franchise, I pick another.
Right.
We actually have three competitive game modes.
Okay.
The two newest ones are Draft Champions. That's the one we're featuring at the Madden Classic. So we have Draft Champions and then Salary Cap. So Draft Champions is all about you're given a base team and you're giving 15 rounds of drafting choices where you're allowed to improve your team.
Right.
So really the skill there is, you know, being able to make intelligent choices about building your team and being flexible, being able to work with almost anything you're given.
Right. It's kind of like a funny, odd twist to like fantasy football. You're kind of sitting there, you're picking, but you want to make the best team.
Yes, you want to assemble your dream team with the choices you have. Yep.
Right. So let's just say there's an update to the game, or a player is hurt or injured or suspended or something like that. How fast do you guys implement that into competitive play?
Yeah, we make updates weekly. There are like 5 days a week we have some sort of update coming out. In some game modes, like head-to-head, it's very realistic. If someone gets injured, you know, they're moved to the bench. You can't use them. In modes like Draft Champions, we have items we release, like a team of the week. So we'll release an updated version of a new player. We also have like retro players. Like you can play Emmitt Smith in Draft Champions and Salary Cap. Like we have those legends who come out, and we let you use them in Madden still.
So like Brett Favre or Dorsey Levens or Antonio Freeman, like. Old school Packers players, can I play as them?
There are, you know, it's a surprise. You know, we don't tell you what's going on the entire season, but there's some cool stuff coming out there, and there's some cool legends all the time, especially on the Packers.
I just was trying to find a way to throw my Packer fandom into the show because I just had to do that. Plus, you're a Packers fan.
Yeah, exactly. So, like last year, I think we had a very popular Amon Green card.
That was the
highlight legend Packer player from last year.
Right.
Yeah.
All right. So every year, there's always those certain plays that the pros take advantage of, and they you know, they utilize it, abuse it, whatever you want to call it. What are some of the most popular offensive plays that are used often this year?
You know, you're right, like just like the NFL, like every coach practices his like third and goal play or that play that in the must win do or die scenario. All of our Madden players have their version of those plays, but there's no one play. You know, some people used to call them like money plays.
Right.
We're balancing Madden constantly, so there's no like one play that dominates the scene here. Madden has a meta, just like the NFL has a meta. Like in the NFL, the passing game is popular.
Mm-hmm.
Having a wide receiver like tight end, like a Gronkowski, is a factor that, you know, teams win Super Bowls based on that, and that's why my Packers aren't doing so well. They need to upgrade a little bit there.
Bubba Franks come back.
Yeah. or JerMichael.
Yeah. JerMichael Finley. Yeah. Yeah, one of your guys.
Yeah, someone come back, please. But no, so, you know, Madden, there certainly is a meta, right? There certainly is a style of play, but we're constantly balancing, tweaking the games, much like we update the players on a weekly basis. We're also looking at what plays are getting used, why are they effective.
Right.
And we balance those plays, too, to make sure that, you know, there's just not one way to play Madden. We want to have it. We want to make sure that it's available for many styles of play, whether you're a runner or a passer or really heavy on defense.
That's excellent, man. All right, so what people might not know about you is you were there at Riot when they first started the LCS. Are you always studying all the other esports leagues and all the other esports initiatives out there?
Yeah, I mean, honestly, my inspiration of kind of gaming comes from sports. I've been a lifelong sports fan. I grew up in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, huge Green Bay Packer fan.
Right.
So that's really my inspiration. You know, one thing actually I noticed about esports is I actually feel a lot of esports games take their production too seriously. It's like they've got a chip on their shoulder.
Thank you.
It's like they got a chip on their shoulder, like, oh, we have to be super serious and prove we're legitimate. And that's not what competition is fun is all about. So, you know, one of the things we're trying to do here with Madden is, like, really bring the fun to competitive gaming. And we think we're in an awesome position to do that. Like, everyone in America knows and loves football for the most part, right? It's a very understandable, identifiable game. So we don't need to teach you the sport of football. So we really want to focus on having fun, you know, with our talent.
Right.
Making one of our platforms is to make stars of our players. You know, we want to have engaging audience experiences. So that's really what we're building to with the Madden program. And, you know, we want to really shed this, and we have the right audience that, you know, gamers are super cerebral nerds. They don't have fun, they take everything seriously. Madden, we want to buck that trend. And I think if you tune into the Madden Classic this week, you'll see that.
What kind of hurdles have you faced trying to get Madden to go into the competitive scene with esports kind of being established with some other games?
Yeah, no, Madden is an esport, or any sport game is a competitive game, is a natural fit. I think for some people it's a little counterintuitive. They're like, well, wait a minute, why wouldn't I just watch the sport?
Right.
But that's not the point of it. The point of it is it's a digital version. It's a version of the game that anyone can play. I don't need to be a 6'4", you know, 260-pound linebacker, right, to enjoy Madden and show off my football acumen, right? So I think one of the challenges, and I think it's easy to overcome, is just explain to people like who maybe are not as familiar with Madden, like, well, why would I play Madden? It's really the ability over playing football. It's really the ability to show off your football smarts, the ability to play any role in football instead of just being limited to one role. So that's one thing that, you know, some people don't quite get, but I think it'll be obvious watching the Classic. The other thing, to be honest with you, is that console gaming, the technology has always been a little bit behind a PC.
Right.
But
nowadays,
you know, you have streaming that's built into the consoles. You have great internet connection.
Right.
So a lot of the challenges that existed with consoles in the past, not being connected to the internet, a lot of those are gone. And now as a development team, we have the freedom to do a lot of really great stuff.
Yeah, right. And you know what? I feel like from a competitive standpoint, you know, actual sports games, you know, traditional sports games have been around much longer, you know, as far as like being that thing that people sat down on the couch and played 1-on-1, 1v1.
Yeah, Madden, I mean, honestly, I think was the original console esport here in America.
Yeah.
There have been Madden tournaments for over a decade now. You know, we've been writing $100,000 checks for over a decade. You know, there's been community tournaments, you know, that really, much like any esport, those community tournaments built up the foundation for kind of Madden.
Yeah.
And now we're just trying to add on top of that, right, and really help structure the whole competitive scene.
And I remember Madden was like one of the reasons why I got a network adapter on my PlayStation 2. One of the reasons, man. Well, all right. Well, you guys can catch the Madden Classic right now on twitch.tv/EA Madden NFL. The elimination round will begin tomorrow with a final airing on the NFL Network at 9:30 p.m. Eastern. Matt, thank you so much for stopping by, man.
Great to be here. Go Pack, go.
Go Pack. Go Pack. And that is GG on the week. But if you want more eStream and eSports news, download Bleacher Report's TeamStream app on your phone and select which specific sports teams and eSports titles you want to follow and get updates on. Also, follow us on Twitter and Instagram at @BR_eStream. This weekend is packed with eSports, so make sure you tune in. There's E-League Season 2 Finals, the Capcom Cup, Madden Classic, Vanglory, Rocket League Grand Finals, and the Boston Major. So much stuff going on, and we'll have coverage for you next week. Till then, see you later.